Hello friends, welcome to Grade Up. Okay, today we'll be discussing about the relevance and importance of mock tests. So first, I would like to tell you about myself. I am Anurag Agarwal and I have been training students for CAT and other MBA exams from last 15 years. Okay, and I have been consistently getting more than 99.9 percentile in QA and LRDI section of CAT. So the topic for today is how to utilize CAT 2020 mock tests. So let's begin with this. So the first thing is, why is it important to write mocks? So this is the most important question. Okay. So the first reason why we should write mocks is it helps in testing. It is the only way to test your current level of preparation, okay, and it will help you to measure this accurately and correctly. And by writing mocks, by trying different strategies in mocks, I can customize the strategy which will work best for me. Okay, it is not that one strategy is good for everyone. We need to customize this strategy according to myself, okay, according to my strengths and weaknesses. Then second thing is, it helps to understand these strengths and weaknesses. Okay. So see, what happens is, sometimes what we think may not be the reality. Okay, let's say if I think that I'm very good in time, speed and distance, okay, and I write 10 mocks. And let us say there are a total of 20 questions based on time, speed and distance in the 10 mocks. And out of the 20 questions, let's say I'm able to attempt only 14. And out of 14, let's say only 10 are correct. So I used to think that my time, speed, distance is very good. But the data is saying something else. That data is saying that out of 20, I'm attempting only 14, that is 70%. And I am attempting only 50% of the question correctly. That is 10 out of the 20 questions, the total 20 questions. I just did 10 questions correctly. Okay. So in that way, writing mocks helps. Okay. So it helps to better understand our strengths and weaknesses. Similarly, I can also come to know about my weaknesses and I can work upon improving my weaknesses. So that is also why we should write mocks. Then the grade up mocks are the closest to the actual CAT. So that is why we recommend students to, and we strongly recommend students to write grade up mocks, because this is the closest that you can get to writing actual CAT. Okay. Then it improves our decision making. Okay. And it also makes us better prepared for the actual CAT. Okay. Now see, if I look at the data of the previous years, we can see that only just by solving 50% of the LRDI questions correctly, you can get very easily more than 99%. So that means out of the 32 questions, if I look at the last 3 years, out of the 32 questions in LRDI, okay, you just need to solve 15 to 16 questions to get around 99%. Okay? So that means I can leave half of the section and still be among the toppers, still be among the top 1% of the students. So in such a scenario, the decision making skill plays a very important role. Okay, which caselets to attempt, which caselets to leave. And similarly, I can see that we have a similar scenario in the other sections as well. Okay, to get more than 99 percentile in QA, what we need to do is, out of 34 questions, you need to solve around 22, 23, 24 questions. Okay, it varies depending upon the difficulty level of the paper. So that means in all these, in past, it has been seen that you can leave around 35 to 50% of the section and you can get a very good percentile. So which questions to attempt, which questions to leave plays a very important role. Okay. Knowing which questions to leave, in fact, plays a bigger role than knowing which questions to attempt. So because if I attempt a question which is meant to be not attempted, so what I'll do to myself is I may end up wasting some time. Okay. And since there is a time constraint, the number of questions are fixed, it's a highly competitive exam, so I cannot afford to have 10 minutes or 10 unproductive minutes. Okay, so that is why it is very important which question you, it is very important for you to know which questions to attempt and which question should be avoided. Okay, so that is why the skill that you have in terms of decision making is very important. And this can be improved only by writing sufficient number of mocks. Okay. See, we learn when we commit mistakes. So every failure will be learning to us. Okay. So if I do some blunder in mocks, so I will know that I don't have to repeat the same thing in the next mock, and the same thing will be followed in the actual CAT. But if I write the CAT as the first paper, that means if I write CAT without writing any mock, so it is just like taking a gamble. You are, no matter how much prepared you are, so it is a big gamble if you directly write CAT without writing any mocks. Okay, so that means you are leaving this success of your career, okay, on fate, which is not a very good idea. Then one more important point, it is the best and the only way to develop mental stamina. Okay, and it is also the only way to develop mental ability to give your best under the pressure of time constraint. Okay, if I, let's say if I do a exercise of maths or exercise of LRDI or NRC without any time constraint, so that means what I am trying to do is I am trying to develop my application skills. I am trying to test my understanding of the concepts. And if I continue doing this without writing test, okay, that means I am just testing my application and my understanding of the concepts. And I am not considering the element of the pressure that the time constraint can have on the performance of an individual. Okay, so that is why it is very important to write mocks so that you have the pressure of time constraint. Then, as I said, it is also the only way to develop mental stamina. See, the CAT will be of 2 hours this year. Okay. And if I don't have the habit of giving 100%, okay, of able to focus with my 100% concentration for a continuous duration of 2 hours, then I will there are high chances that I will suffer in the actual CAT. Okay, because this is a problem that many students face, that they are able to do well in the first 1 hour as compared to in the last 1 hour. Okay, so to overcome this, what you need to do is you need to develop mental stamina, and that can be developed by writing mocks. Okay, because mocks, since the pattern has changed, okay, the time duration has changed, so now the new mocks are of 2 hours each. So, if I write mocks, I get or I develop a habit of giving my 100% for the duration of 2 hours, which is very important. So, in all these senses, writing mocks makes sense. Okay. So, now the next thing is how to get maximum out of mocks. See, what most students do, or this a significant number of students do, they don't write sufficient number of mocks. Then there is a category of students who write mocks but they don't analyze. Okay. So the worst thing that you can do is not writing mocks at all. Then the second worst thing that you can do is writing mocks and not analyzing them. So writing mocks is important, but writing mocks and then analyzing mocks is equally important. Okay. So we should analyze the mock. So let's say if I write a mock, okay, then Analyzing a mock takes two times or three times the time spent in writing the mock. So if the mock is of 2 hours, so generally the time that analysis of the mock takes is around 4 to 6 hours, depending upon the student. Okay. So now what does I mean by analyzing the mock? Analysis is just going through the complete paper, okay, and checking where have I gone wrong. If you have attempted, if you have done a question incorrectly, so finding out what error have you done. Was it a silly error or was it a conceptual error? Okay, so the first thing is you should know the mistake that you committed. Okay, so once I am able to figure out the mistake, then it is easier to correct that, rectify that mistake. So the bigger challenge is to find out the mistakes, the shortcomings in you. Okay, so analysis helps in that. Okay. Then it is also very important to check the solution of the questions which you have done correctly. See, there may be a case that you have done a question correctly, but you have used a wrong logic, and by chance you got it correct. The second possibility is you may have applied the correct logic, okay, and got the correct answer, but the method used was not the best one. So you get to know about the better methods of doing the same question, okay, the alternate methods of doing the same question. So in that way also analysis helps a lot. The second thing is solving the unsolved. Okay. Generally what happens is majority of us are not able to solve all the questions in the given time frame. Okay. Let's say there are 20 questions in QA and you have 40 minutes. Okay. So there is a high chances that you would not be able to solve all the 20 questions. Okay. So see what we generally attempt in mocks is what we find easier. Okay, easier according to us. If I am finding some question easy, that means I am able to understand the question. I am able to also figure out the approach of solving the question. I will attempt that question. So generally, let's say if I attempt the QA section of mock CAT, and out of 20 questions, I'm able to solve only 14 questions. Okay, and let us assume that all 14 are correct. So the 6 question that I have not attempted, possibility one is I was finding those 6 questions to be tougher than the remaining 14 questions that I attempted. Okay, or there is a second possibility that I may not have the enough time to attempt all the questions. So in both the cases, it is important to solve the remaining 6 questions, and it will increase my learning. Okay, or the learning that I can take from that particular mock. So it is very important to solve the unsolved. Okay. See, mocks are what? It is basically the collection of best questions in terms of variations, in terms of difficulty level. I'm not saying the questions are very difficult. They are, we try to keep them of the same difficulty level that we are expecting in the actual CAT. Okay, so we try to match them to the actual CAT. So in terms of difficulty level, they are the best. In terms of variation, they are the best. Okay, and it's a mocks are basically compilation of the best questions. So we should not miss out on any good question. So that is why solving the unsolved is important. Analyzing the mock is important. Okay. So it should not be that I'm writing one mock every day without proper analysis. So see, you have to customize the strategy for you. If you write one mock, don't attempt the another one before completely analyzing the first one. Okay. Completely getting to know about the mistakes that you did, about the shortcomings, about your strengths also. Okay, the confidence is also very important in exams like CAT. Okay, we should be confident enough that I am going to do well in CAT. So that is why you should also you should be very sure about your strength as well, and work on your strength as well. Okay, you should never ignore your strength. Yeah, because if I continue doing that, so there are chances that my strength may become our weaknesses as well. So all these things are very important, and that is why mocks are the most important part of your CAT preparation. Okay, knowing concepts, knowing the application of the concepts, then testing the concept is the most important thing. And it has been seen in the past that the students who have done this very good in CAT, they have written a sufficient number of mocks. All the toppers have written the sufficient number of mocks. Okay, this I can tell you from my experiences, from my experience and from my interaction with the toppers, the past toppers of CAT. Okay, now this is about the this Grade Up CAT 20 test series. Okay, you can, as you can see, that the first mock is for free. Anyone can attempt the first mock for free. Okay, so what you will be getting in this test series is 10 plus mock test on the latest CAT pattern, on the latest CAT pattern. This is important, students. Okay, that means a 2 hours pattern. Okay, then you will be getting 15 plus sessional test for CAT, 40 plus mock test of other MBA exams. Okay, like SNAP, IAFT, NMAT, CMAT, all these exams, ZAT. So 40 plus mocks of all the other MBA exams. We'll be covering everything, and it is available both on web and app. So it's a suggestion. It's a strong. I strongly suggest that start practicing now. Don't waste any time. Okay, this is a good news for you guys. Okay, you can have this 6 months validity for this much and 3 months validity for this. Okay, so it's a huge discount on the occasion of Diwali. And it's you can avail this green card. Then this is about the CAT 2020 actual exam analysis. So Grade Up will bring the live exam analysis, okay, question discussion right after your exam. On 29th November, shift 1 analysis begins at 10:45 a.m. Shift 2 analysis begins at 2:45 p.m. Shift 3 analysis at 6:45 p.m. And I'm assuring you about the analysis that you can definitely trust to be the you can say the most accurate analysis of the exam, okay, done by the pool of expert faculties we have. And I request you guys to subscribe to our channel and stay tuned. Okay, now this is about the free series. It is the free series for the final revision of CAT 2020 with 100% IELTS. The mentors are experts, senior faculty members who have been toppers in the past. Okay, so this is the complete schedule of that. So I think some of you must be attending this, must be following this series. So we have quite a few sessions left. So as you can see, some of the sessions are left, and the recording of the sessions, these sessions, you can watch the videos. Okay, you either you can download the app and or you can visit on the web also. As you can see, do not miss the revision classes in the playlist section. All the videos are there. So we have covered, we have tried to cover every important concept. Okay, so it is the final revision. Then this is about the ongoing and upcoming courses. Okay, comprehensive course started on 9th November. That means just a few days back. Okay, for CAT 2021 students. For CAT 20 students, we have started a batch very recently, and it is for the students targeting IAFT, TISNET, CMAT, MAT, MARA CT, All these are very popular and important exams. See, we should not bank on just one exam only. So that is why it is important to write other MBA exams, okay, even if my preparation is very good. Then this is about the CAT 2020 bootcamp with 100 percentiler. All these are ongoing courses, started on 5th, started on 14th. GK and current affairs course for IAFT, ZAT, CMAT started on 7th. You will get the classes that you have made, that you have missed as recorded videos. Then this is the 18-month subscription. We recommend this or highly recommend this for students targeting CAT 2021. 3 months and 6 months for those, 3 months for those who are writing CAT this year as well as taking other MBA school exams. For example, IAFT, TISNAT, Maharashtra CT. So this is all what you'll be getting in Grade Up Super Subscription. You will be getting the structured life courses, complete doubt resolution, full syllabus coverage, and all this will be by expert faculty members. The classes that you have missed are there, are available there as recorded videos, okay, and your complete performance analysis in the form of report cards. This is about the vast pool of faculty members we have. The faculty members are very senior experts, they are toppers, okay. And all the best for your preparation. So I end this session here, guys. Thank you so much.